Do we generously share with others the mercy we have freely received from our Lord? A blessed Saturday, brothers and sisters. This is our reflection question for today.
Holy Spirit, make my heart open to the Word of God. Make my heart open to goodness. Make my heart open to the beauty of God. Every day, amen.
The first canonized saint of the New World, Saint Rose, was born in Lima, Peru, in 1586, when South America was in its first century of evangelization. Her parents were both of Spanish descent. From an early age, Saint Rose wanted to become a nun, but her parents opposed it because they wanted her to marry. And so Saint Rose often cloistered herself, praying for extended hours. Also because her beauty was often admired, she rubbed her face with pepper to produce disfiguring blotches. When her parents ran into financial difficulties, she spent her days working in the garden and her nights sewing. Her parents still refused to let her enter a convent. Out of obedience to her parents, she resumed her life of penance and seclusion at home as a member of the Third Order of Saint Dominic. She devoted most of her time in solitude. She yearned to emulate Christ. In the final years of her life, Saint Rose established a chamber in the house where she provided care for the sick, the elderly, and the homeless children. In Peru, this marked the start of social services. She was brought to the notice of Inquisition interrogators, who could only conclude that she was influenced by grace. What has been merely an ordinary life was transformed from the inside. If we can recall any peculiar penances, we must also remember the greatest thing about Saint Rose. Her love for God was so intense that it endured mockery from others, violent temptation, and lengthy periods of illness. Saint Rose died on August 25, 1617, at 31 years old. Legend has it that she foresaw her death date with accuracy. All of the city's officials attended her funeral, which was a significant occasion. She was beatified by Pope Clement IX in 1667, and in 1671, Pope Clement X declared her to be a saint. Around the world, August 23 is her feast day. However, certain nations like Peru honor her on August 30. It will be as when a man who was going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the one who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. Bishop Robert Barrett, in his reflection, September 22, 2014, said that the usual interpretation of the parable of the talents is that talents refer to gifts and ability. Bishop Barron further discussed that Father Robert Schoenstein, an Old Testament professor, specified that a talent in ancient times was a measure of something particularly weighty or heavy, usually silver or gold, weighing as much as 50 pounds of precious metal. In Jewish tradition, the talents is connected to heaviness or gravitas, the kabod of Yahweh. And this kabod of Yahweh was to be found in the Temple of Jerusalem, resting upon the mercy seat within the Holy of Holies, the place of God's presence. In this light, Bishop Barron said that the talents given to the servants were not so much monetary gifts or personal capacities, but a share in the mercy of God. The mercy of God received as a pure gift was meant to be given to others as pure gift as well. As pure gifts from the Lord, the talents increase in the measure that they are given away. By clinging to it as a possession, the timid servant who buried the one talent given to him fails to realize that by doing so, the talent eventually vanishes or fades away. Our Lord said to Saint Faustina Kowalska that all grace flows from mercy, and we should always be merciful as He is merciful. Love everyone out of love for me, even your greatest enemies, so that my mercy may be fully reflected in your heart. The chance encounter of Saint Joan of the Cross with Francois Fouché, a poor widowed pilgrim from Rennes, led her to be merciful and loving to the less fortunate in her community. Despite living a life of seclusion in prayer and penance, Saint Rose of Lima's generous spirit shone as she cared for the sick and poor in a room in her parents' house. Do we generously share with others the mercy we have freely received from our Lord? Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Help us, Lord, that our hands may be merciful and full of good works, that we may only do good to others. Help us, Lord, that our feet may be merciful, so that we may hurry to assist others, overcoming our fatigue and tiredness. Our true rest is in the service of our neighbor. Help us, Lord, that our hearts may be merciful, so that we may feel all the suffering of our neighbors. We will refuse our hearts to no one. We will be sincere, even with those who we know will abuse our kindness. And we will lock ourselves up in the most merciful heart of Jesus. We will bear our own sufferings in silence. May your mercy, O Lord, rest upon us. Jesus, King of mercy, we trust in you. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic Church and Couples for Christ.